Okay, we're gonna try to make some stencils here. I found this image of some mushrooms that I wanted to use for my stencils, and the first thing I did was trace the section of it in pencil that I wanted to turn into a stencil. So looking at just that line drawing, I have to figure out now what I'm going to make black and what's going to be white. Your stencil drawing can be black and white shapes, and you'll be cutting out the black shapes in order to create your stencil. So the first image I went with looked like this. Wasn't really happy with the area here. It just looks a little bit awkward. Don't really like that. So I drew it again. This one I like a lot more. There's a better distinction between the foreground and background in this area. Over here, it just looks kind of ambiguous. And I still wasn't really crazy about this area, so I drew it one more time. And here you can see how it is just an outline. And you're really not gonna know what this looks like until you fill in all the shapes that you're gonna be cutting out with the black Sharpie. So you might think it's working out okay, but after you fill in the shapes, there might be something you don't like. Here, where you see in the drawing where the background is just this big black shape, you can't leave it one big black shape. So what you have to do is divide those little spaces into sections, and you create what I call like little bridges. So instead of a giant black shape here, I'm gonna cut it down into several, and I separate each of the shapes by these little tiny bridges. You can see when I erase that pencil line, it's a little better. Use your Sharpie, fill in every shape that you've outlined. And as you can see right now, as I'm moving along with my Sharpie, it's starting to really take form of the stencil that we're gonna be using for the painting project. Maybe in these tiny shapes, I'm gonna switch to a smaller tip Sharpie. Okay, so what I've done here then, I think I like this one the best. Oops. One thing I'm gonna add though that I like from the other drawing are these little dots on the sides of the mushrooms. Down here, I have some of this. You add a couple dots to it, and in the bigger one, and some larger shapes. Okay, so the next step that you'll do is to draw these on the acetate and then cut out your shapes.